If you like working with images in Canva, you have a lot of options, including the ability to add them to an image frame or grid. A frame is simply a placeholder that allows you to put an image or even a video inside of it, and it will then take on that shape. Other programs might call this an image mask or an image container. In Canva, it's called a frame. And today, I'm going to share 7 fun tips for using image frames and grids to enhance your Canva designs. My name is Kat, and this is Canva Caturday. To find these image frames, you are going to use the Elements tab in Canva. So we'll click on Elements and then scroll down until you see Frames and Grids. We'll work with Frames first. There are a whole bunch of different shapes that you can use. I've already added one to a design right here. And then all you do is find an image, drag it on top, and it will automatically be placed inside that frame. If you don't quite like the placement or you want to zoom in a little bit, just double click on the image and you can adjust where that photo falls like this, or even zoom in a little bit on a certain section of that photo. Well, tip number one has to do with how to make this have a little bit more pizzazz, a little more of a pop. It's fine just like it is, but it might just need a little something extra, especially if you happen to have maybe a background color with this image. So what we're going to do is actually add a border to this image frame. To do that, click on the image, click on duplicate, and then take the image and put it directly on top. So you've got one right on top of the other. Then you want to slightly reduce the size of the front image like that, and then click on the back image. And now we're going to change the color. So click on the color box. You can pick any color you like. Canva gives you some color suggestions based on the colors that are in your photo. So I'll just choose that one. That's a nice green one. You can pick any one of the other colors that are here, or you can choose your own. Click on the color box and then click on the eyedropper. And if you hover over your image, you have the option to choose any color that's here within this photo. So we could click that one if we like. It's kind of cool, shows up that blueberries right there. And then you have a great way to showcase this, just gives it like that little bit of an outline. Well, you can take this one step farther by giving it a drop shadow. So to do that, go over to the share and then click download. And you want to download this as a transparent background PNG file. So click on transparent, make sure PNG is selected as the file type and click download. And then we're going to bring this back into Canva. Let me just add a new page and I will grab that download, bring it right back in. There's our image and we're going to add this to our design. And we can edit this and give it a drop shadow because since we imported it back into Canva, Canva thinks this is now a whole image. So you'll go up here to edit photo, shadows, and then drop shadow. And it adds that little drop shadow, it gives it just like a little bit of extra depth, kind of make it look like it's 3D and popping off that page. There are hundreds of different frame styles within Canva, but if you're looking for something a little more unique, I have some custom design frames that are available in my online shop. Everything from animals to work-related holidays. I even have some fun letter frames in there. So I will put the link in the description and you can just click on that and go check those out for yourself. Tip number two is about using letter frames because yes, there are letter frames in Canva. So let's scroll down to frames. And if you type letter, you have the entire alphabet in here, including different styles and shapes. I have a set right here that I've done. Now, I mentioned earlier that you can add images to frames, you can add videos to frames, you can even add colors or gradients to frames. But what we're going to do here, we're going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to add this video to my image frame, and then I'm going to make it look like this video is going through all of the frames at the same time. And it's a really neat trick. So grab a video and drag it inside one of the letters and then continue to do this for the other letter frames that you have on your page. Grab that one and grab that one. Now I'm going to grab my ruler lines here and I'm going to put a little guideline right here at the beginning of the W and right at the end of the W. You'll see why in just a second. Next, you're going to double click on the first frame. And we want to take this video and make it so that it expands the entire width of my word. So I'm going to slide this over all the way there to the right. And then I'm going to drag the handles up or down. Doesn't really matter which one you choose. And I'm going to drag it right to that other guideline so that it looks like it's covering all of those letters. And then you want to repeat this with the other letters. So I'm going to drag it this way for my middle letter. And then we'll do the third one and drag this down. So now it's inside all of my letters. Watch what happens when I hit play. That video flows through all of those letters, so it looks like one seamless video. It's a really, really cool effect. And you can do this with any video that's in Canva. If you have a longer word, you would just have to adjust that video to make sure that it covers all of the letters in that word. And you can drag it up and down. You just want to make sure that when you're doing it, the placement is exactly the same for each one of those letters. Tip number three is about frames and image rotation. Let's say I have this image right here and I want it to be horizontal like this. If I drag an image or video inside of this frame, look what happens. It puts it in the wrong orientation. And that's because I rotated the frame before I put the image in there. So you want to do this in reverse. Instead of rotating the frame first, you want to rotate the image and then you can place it inside the frame. So I'm going to grab this image. I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees. Then I'm going to drag it inside of the frame. And now I can rotate the frame and it's the correct orientation. If the image placement isn't exactly how I want it, I can just double click and bring it up a little bit. I can even zoom in a little like that and then just drag it into place. And that solves the issue of having that frame and that image not quite aligning properly. And you can do this with images as well as videos. Just make sure that you rotate the image first and then you can rotate the frame. Tip number four is about using image grids to create collages. So we are going to go down here to grids. You have a bunch of options available. They have different sizes, different layouts. I believe the most that you can use is 16, but we're just gonna grab one right here. It will add it to your design. By default, it will make it equal. It'll fill the whole page. You can adjust this size if you want to, bring it up or down. You'll notice that there's these divider lines here, this white spacing. You can get rid of that if you want. Go up here to spacing, and you can drag the grid spacing down so that there's no spacing, or if you want, you can drag it up so you have a little bit of spacing, a little bit of extra room in there. What else you can do with this, you'll notice by default, it's got white spacing. If you don't want it to be white, you can change that color because what it's doing is just showing the background of your design. So let's just move this out of the way. I'm gonna click on my background, grab a color. Let's do that one. And you can see there, now those lines in between take on the color of my background. So it's a great way to color coordinate the images that you have here with your background. You can also resize these grid and make combination grids. Maybe there's a grid that doesn't quite suit your needs. You can change that by combining different grids together. So let's bring this down a little bit like that. And maybe I want to add like a header image here. So I'm going to go back down to grids. I'm going to add this single grid right here. You'll notice by default, it takes on the whole page. We don't want that. I'm just going to drag this up. And now I have a custom grid. And you can continue to add additional grids to this if you want to. If your canvas is large enough, you can add as many grids as you want and put all those photos and or videos right inside there. You can also take any of these grids and just fill them with a solid color or with a gradient. This is tip number five. If you have a product or service-based business, you can actually make bingo boards for your social media accounts to help with some fun engagement. Go to the very bottom of the grids. You see one right here. I've got this 16 block grid right here. I'm going to click on that, add that to the design. I'm going to bring this down just a little bit from the top because I want to be able to put a heading, and I'll bring in the sides and the bottom as well, just to give it a bit of a border, because I want to put a colored border behind here. So I have it like this. I'm going to click my background. I'll add a fun color. And then we'll just use the T key on our keyboard and type the word bingo. Bring that up and change the font to whatever you would like it to be. You can make the size larger, whatever you want, just like that. And now what you can do is take your products or services and just drag them inside each one of these frames. So let's go grab some products. We'll grab a couple like this. You can put one there, right here, and you can continue to drag your products inside each of these frames and then adjust them accordingly. If you want to change the size, just double click inside that specific space and you can bring it up a little bit like that. Maybe you want to highlight a little closer to this one, like that. And you will continue to do this by adding your products in here. Then all you have to do is add some text and put numbers right here on these boxes. So I will just do a text box and I'll just do a number one. It doesn't need to be that big. Let's bring it down a little bit. Let's bring it down to about 42. There we go. You can put it right there. And then just duplicate those numbers and put them on each one of the frames, change the number, and continue to do that across your bingo board. And now you've got a fun way to interact with your social media audience. You can put this on Facebook or Instagram and have a really fun way to collaborate and showcase your product by playing a bingo game with them using these grids. Tip number six is to use an image grid instead of a frame if you need an exact dimension. The one downfall of using frames is that they have a preset size. So if I were to choose any one of these frames, I can drag the corner handles, but I can't really change the proportions of the frame itself. It's a set dimension. So if I have a photo that I want to place inside here and it's not exactly this type of proportion, it's going to crop my image. It's going to cut it off a little bit. So to fix that, you can actually use a grid instead. So let me go to grids and I will show you. I'm going to add a grid right here and I'm just going to bring this grid down like this and just move it to the side. And now I'm going to grab a photo. So let's go to photos right there. We're going to grab that photo. So to see what the exact proportions are of that image, whether you've uploaded it yourself or whether it's already within Canva, you can click on the Get Info button. But an easier way to do that is to click on Position. And here are the dimensions of that image. So you can see that this one here is 1295.6 by 864. We're going to bring this down a little bit because that's a big image. Let me just bring it down some. And I'm going to make this just 860. There we go, 860 by 572.5. You can see that this grid right here, I've got these side handles, I can stretch it out. I've got these bottom handles, I can make it taller. So this is where the grid really has that strength because now I can make this the exact proportions of this image and it won't get cut off. So since this particular image is 860 by 572.5, I'm going to make the grid the exact same size. Click on the grid and go over here. We'll resize it. 860 by 572.5. I think it was 5. Is that right? It was 572.5. So we have them the exact same size. And when I drag the photo in there, there's no cropping. If I double click, it's the exact size that I need. So this is a great way if you've got an unusually sized image or maybe something that's really narrow or really long, you can use these grids to get the exact frame that you're looking for. And just like I mentioned about outlining these frames, you can create your own custom outlines just by duplicating this image, putting it behind and giving it a colored border. Tip number seven is to use grids to create your own custom border. This one's really cool. So I'm going to add just a single grid right here. I'm going to drag this up so it looks like I have a border style. Because this is a grid and it's a container, it will hold anything that I want. I can put a color in here. I can even put a gradient in here. So let me grab a color. I'm going to grab that right there. I'll use one of Canva's preset gradient colors, like maybe that one. It's a pretty one. Once you have that, take that grid and duplicate it. So I'm going to duplicate this one right here. And then I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees. I'm going to bring it over here to the side. And look what I'm doing. I'm creating like a gradient style border for this image. And there's a little bit of a demarcation line right here where the two gradients meet. To fix that, just resize that a little bit, just like that, kind of like a puzzle piece. And then you're going to just repeat this process for each of the sides that you need. So we're going to duplicate this one, bring it to this side, and I'm going to rotate it the other way, flip it around so that the pinks meet up like that. And then I'm going to do this one more time. And I'm going to rotate it the other way like this and bring that down here and adjust it here as well, just so that they meet up. There's a fun gradient border. Once you have it like that, you can actually change those colors if you want to. If I want a different style of gradient, I can do that. I can click right here and I can adjust my gradients this way. I can click each one of these and adjust my gradients accordingly to fill with different colors. Now, if you want to place an image inside of that, once again, you're going to click on the single grid and then just resize it down so that it falls right in the middle. And you can place an image inside of here. Let's go grab an image we did earlier. That one like that. There you go. We have a great colored border that we can use. You can also put videos inside here. So if there's like a really cool video and you want to kind of make it look like it's a border, you can do that as well by using grids and just adjusting this size. You can bring this up or down. You can make it fatter. You can make it super skinny, whatever you like. You can even do some fun things like create stripes by taking this line right here and then just copying it and bringing it down some. All kinds of fun things that you can do with this because you can resize that grid into different sizes. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of my future content and you can stay up to date on all the fun Canva tips. That's all for this week. I'll see you next time.